Hello students, welcome back to the session wherein we will again discuss another problem based on the relative velocity method. Okay, as you can see in the diagram, it's a toggle mechanism. So let us just read out the problem. In the toggle mechanism as shown in figure, the crank OA, as you can see, there is a crank, okay, OA rotates at 210 RPM. So the speed is 210. Counterclockwise, increasing at the rate of 60 radians per second square. So 60 radians per second square is the alpha given, that is the angular acceleration given. So for the given configuration, determine velocity of slider D. So there is a slider attached at the end of this mechanism. So we have to find out the velocity of the slider, angular velocity of link BD. So you can see the link BD. So you can see here, this is link BD. So we need to find out the angular velocity of link BD, then acceleration of slider D, acceleration of slider D, and angular acceleration of link BD, angular acceleration of link BD. Okay, so now let us move on with the problem. So this is the given data, okay? So from this point here, from this fixed point Q to O, it is 400. Okay, all of them are in millimeter only. So from A to B, our link AB measures 400 millimeter, QB measures 300 millimeter, so Q to O, this point, okay, is 150. Okay, this link BD is 500. There is again another fixed point G. Okay, link OA or the crank measures 200. Okay, so let's move on with the problem now. So using this data, we need to first construct the configuration diagram. So now, as I have already told you and always I tell you that, construct the given diagram as per the comfortable scale. While constructing the configuration diagram, so you can take the scale of your choice. Even constructing the velocity diagram as well as the acceleration diagram also, you can construct, you can consider your own scale, but while you get the results afterwards, you have to convert that by considering the scale you have taken. Okay, so now configuration diagram, you can draw as per your comfort. So if you have a very big page, you can draw a big scale, or if you have very small page, or if you're drawing on some A4 sheet, you can just rotate it and you can draw. You just have to first calculate and then draw the configuration diagram. So configuration diagram is very important here, okay, because you need to analyze the velocity vectors using the configuration diagram only. So okay, so now let us just finish this off quickly. So draw the configuration diagram according to the given dimensions and according to your scale, your comfort, okay? So this is the configuration diagram drawn. Okay, now we know that omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60 and n is also given in the problem. So that is 210 RPM. So use that value and find out omega, okay, for the crank, that is 22 radians per second, 22 radians per second. Okay, so alpha is given for the crank, so no issues with that. Okay, let us move on to the, finding the velocity. Okay, so velocity of VOA or VAO, sorry, VAO, or directly can be written as VA. Okay, can be found out using the formula omega into omega A into, okay, the link length OA. So omega is, we have found out 22, link length is 0.2. So that will give you the value of 4.4 meter per second. So you have found out one of the velocities. This is more than enough to draw the velocity diagram. Correct. So let us move on to draw the velocity diagram. Okay, so first of all, mark the fixed points. Here you have three fixed points, O, G and Q. Yes, O, G and Q, correct. So mark those points. Let us take the scale. So it's a very smaller value, 4.4 meter per second. So what you can do is you can consider 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter per second. So you can draw 4.4 centimeters, right? So that is why I have taken 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter per second. If it was 400, if it was 40, then you should think about it. Okay, because it is a very smaller value, 4.4 meter per second. So directly you can take 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter per second. So now consider three fixed points. That is Q, G and O. Okay, now consider the first link or crank OA, velocity vector at perpendicular to this, as we have already discussed. Okay, now you people are, I think, masters in this, correct? So velocity acts perpendicular to this. Okay, so take your set square, draw a perpendicular line to OA, exactly perpendicular line to OA. So, and what is the, yes, now what is the dimension for that? 4.4 centimeters, correct? 4.4 centimeters. And as it is rotating in the counterclockwise direction, this has to be drawn upwards, not downwards, correct? This has to be drawn upwards. So, show that as VAO, VAO, correct? Now, let us consider the next link, that is AB. Now, take a set square, find out a perpendicular line and draw a perpendicular line to that. Okay. We don't know the magnitude for this. So, you can draw a line of unknown magnitude. You can draw a line of unknown magnitude. Now, consider the next link. Okay. Now, consider the next link, that is QB. Draw a perpendicular line from Q. From Q, draw a perpendicular line of unknown magnitude, of unknown magnitudes. Okay. Now we have obtained the point B. Now we have another link BC, correct? We have another link BC. So this is V, or velocity of B with respect to Q, fixed point Q. So that is velocity of B with respect to A, correct? So now let us consider the last link, that is BG, correct? So take a set square, get the perpendicular line for that and draw it here. From B, draw a perpendicular line. So if you draw it upwards, there is no meaning at all. So draw it downwards. So draw it downwards for unknown magnitude, for unknown magnitude. Now once it is done, so the last remaining link is the slider. So it will only move horizontally. So there will be no rotation for that. So therefore, draw a horizontal line from G and mark the point D. And mark the point D. Now, calculate or measure all the velocities using your scale. So scale is taken as 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter per second. So it will be very easy now. Okay, you don't have to convert it at all. So whatever the value you get, okay, will be your meter per second. Okay, will be your velocity magnitude, magnitude of the velocity. So now measure the velocity vectors in magnitude for all the links. That is, first one, we have already found out VAO or VA. So that is 4.4 meter per second. Now, second one, measure. Okay, now measure all the other velocities. Now take down or take VBA, let us say, or VBQ, any of the, okay, velocities you consider, and VBA, let us measure. So it will come around 1.5 into 1, that is 1.5 meter per second. Next, similarly, we can measure all the values. So VBQ is equal to 3.5 centimeters and into 1 is equal to 3.5 meter per second. So similarly, VDB is equal to 3.1 meter per second. And finally, VD. Okay, measure VD. This is the line VD. Okay, O to D. This is the line VD or VDG. Velocity of slider with respect to the fixed point G. So it is 2.5 centimeter into 1, that is 2.5 meter per second. So using this, you can calculate the angular velocities also. So omega BD is equal to VDB divided by BD, that is equal to 3.1 divided by 0.5. So you can get the value, use your calculator and find out the value. It is 6.2 radians per second. So this has been asked in the question. Okay, find out the angular velocity of the link BD. Okay, now let us draw the acceleration diagram for the given mechanism. Okay, again, the acceleration diagram or acceleration, okay, consists of two components. One is radial and another one is the tangential acceleration. So when you consider the radial acceleration, it can be found out using the formula V by A, V square by A. So for that, or for the link OA, you can have VAO square divided by AO, that is equal to 4.4 square divided by 0.2. VAO is already being calculated, correct? So the value obtained is 96.8 meter per second square. Here, unlike the other problems which we have solved, alpha is given, correct? Alpha is given. Alpha is 60. Therefore, multiply it by R, you can get the value of tangential acceleration. You can get the value of tangential acceleration, that is 12 radians per second square. Now consider the second link BA. Similarly, you have two components for BA also here. Okay, so that is AR of BA and AT of BA. So AR of BA can be found out by using the formula BA square divided by the link length BA. So that is VBA, we have found out the value of VBA is 1.5 square divided by the link length BA, that is 0.4. So the value will be 5.57 radians per second, meter per second square. Okay, now AT of BA is not known because alpha is not known for that particular link. So we have to find out AT of BA using the acceleration diagram, as well as the corresponding angular acceleration can also be found out using the acceleration diagram. So once you measure AT of BA, you can find out the alpha. Okay, now let us consider the next link BQ. So again, it has two components, AR of BQ and AT of BQ. AR of BQ is given by B square BQ divided by the link length BQ. So that is equal to, so V square BQ we have found out 3.5. So 3.5 square divided by the link length BQ, that is 0.3. So that will be equal to 38.965 meter per second square. Okay, so once you have found out this, so AT of BQ can be found out using the acceleration diagram. Using the acceleration diagram, correct? So now let's consider the other link, that is finally DB. So DB again has two components, AR of DB or AR of BD and AT of BD. Okay, AR of BD can be calculated using the formula V square DB divided by DB. So V square DB we have found out, that is 3.1 square divided by the link length DB is equal to 0.5. So after calculating it, you get the value of 19.7 meter per second square for the radial component of acceleration for the link DB. And now the tangential component can be found out using the acceleration diagram. Now DG or the slider D, okay, can directly be found out using the acceleration diagram, because A acceleration or acceleration of D, okay, can be found out using the acceleration diagram itself directly, because as you people know, slider will move only horizontally. Okay, so therefore there will be no radial or tangential component for that. So only resultant can be found out directly. So now see, the highest value here is 38.965. So you cannot draw 38.96, 38.9 or 40 centimeters. So what I'll do, I'll just convert that into 1 centimeter is equal to 10 meter per second square. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 meter per second square. So now this will become 9.7, this will become 1.2, this will become 0.6. Equal to 0.6, almost equal to 0.6. Then this will become 3.9, almost equal to 3.9. This will become, or it will be almost equal to 2 centimeters. Let's start drawing the acceleration diagram. Now mark the points O dash, Q dash, and G dash. Okay, O dash, Q dash, and G dash. Consider all the links. As I have told you, the radial component of acceleration acts parallel to the link, and the tangential component of acceleration acts perpendicular to the link. Okay, now mark O dash, Q dash, G dash. Okay, go to the configuration diagram. Consider the first link or the crank OA. Okay, so it acts parallel to it. So we know the value for that. AR component of OA is known. So draw it for the given or found out dimensions. Okay, that is OA. Ten point six centimeters. So draw using a dotted line. Why? Because we have got the tangential component also for this link OA. Okay, now tangential component acts perpendicular to this link. Okay, and the magnitude is also known in this particular problem. The magnitude is also known. Okay, so draw a perpendicular line for that. okay, for the given value, that is AT of AO is drawn. Now, if you connect these two points, okay, you can get the acceleration, that is A dash. So if you connect A dash to O dash, you can get the resultant acceleration. You can get the resultant acceleration. So see, let us draw it using a different color so that you can understand it clearly, the resultant accelerations. Okay, so draw a line connecting A dash to O dash so that you can get the resultant acceleration. See here, as you can see, AR of AO and AT of AO have same directions. So therefore, the resultant acceleration will be having an opposite direction. Okay, now consider the second link, BA. Again, we have two components, radial component and tangential component. So consider the link in the configuration diagram. Draw parallel line representing the AR of BA. Okay, and perpendicular line representing the AT of BA. So see here, parallel line representing AR of BA, and exactly perpendicular to that line, draw a line representing AT of BA. Now consider the other link, BQ. So the radial component acts parallel to that link. So now draw a line parallel to it. From Q, draw a line parallel to it. Represent it as AR of BQ. AR of BQ. Now draw a perpendicular line to that. So if you draw it upwards, so I think there is no meaning at all. So we have to draw it downwards. Once again, there is a mistake. Nothing. Actually, I have selected a different color. Okay. In black color, we will draw and we'll show the AR of BQ. So, okay, perpendicular to this line, draw the tangential component also. So, you can go to the configuration diagram and see the perpendicular line, or get the perpendicular line, or else you have drawn the radial component of acceleration. So, exactly perpendicular to that, you can draw a line. So, okay, represent it as AT of BQ. AT of BQ. So, now you have marked the point B dash. So, if you connect B dash to O dash, or if you connect B dash to G dash, you can get the resultant acceleration of BQ, link BQ. Correct? So, this is the resultant acceleration of BQ. Now, consider the last link DB. Okay, so again, okay, the radial component acts parallel to it. From B, draw a line parallel to the link BD, which is equal to 0.6 millimeter. See, very small line. So while drawing in pencil, okay, you should be very careful. Use thick lines and thin lines. Okay, using a single pencil itself, you can do that. Okay, if you put pressure, more pressure, okay, the thick lines will be made. If you put less pressure, thin lines will be made. You can use dotted lines also in order to represent the things. Okay, once you have marked AR of DB, okay, exactly parallel to it, exactly perpendicular to it, draw another line representing AT of BE. Draw another line representing AT of C. This is the AT of DB, AT of DB. Now, the final thing, D, that is the slider. The slider moves horizontally, so there is no need to worry about it. Just draw a horizontal line from G, which connects to this line AT DB. Okay, this is d dash. If you connect b dash to d dash, you will get the resultant acceleration of bd. Okay, and this is the resultant acceleration of a. Okay, if you connect d dash to b dash here or b dash to d dash, you will get the resultant acceleration of bd. Okay, now measure all the accelerations. So now measure slider acceleration, that is 1.9. Well, if you measure it, it will come 1.9 into 10, because we have taken 1 centimeter is equal to 10 meter per second square. So therefore 1.9 into 10, that is 19 meter per second square. So angular acceleration of BD. So alpha dB is equal to 80 dB divided by dB. So measure this 80 dB. What is that? So okay, measure. Yeah, this is here. This is measure 80 dB. This is the line. Measure this. It will come around 5.2 centimeters into 10 divided by 0.5, the original link length of dB. So 52 divided by 0.5 will give you the value of alpha dB, and that is equal to 104 radians per second square. 104 radians per second square. This is it, students. So this is how any mechanism, don't worry about the complexity of the mechanism. In the upcoming videos, I'll put the complex mechanism also. Okay. So crank and throttle demo mechanism, maybe I'll solve a problem on that also. So next topic while we discuss is, after the problems, while we discuss is, okay, we have discussed only two components of acceleration, that is radial and tangential. There is another component of acceleration, okay, when a body is sliding on the another moving body. When a body is moving or sliding on another moving body, we have another type of acceleration, okay, emerging over there or occurring over there. So that will be discussed in the next video maybe. Okay, next video, okay, we will discuss about two more problems, so complex problems. And then we will discuss about the acceleration, type of acceleration I am talking about. When a body, okay, sliding body, when a body slides on a moving body or a rotating body, so we have, or we will get a new type of acceleration, that is Coriolis component of acceleration. Coriolis component of acceleration. So that will be discussed in the upcoming videos. Okay, thanks for now. Stay tuned, be safe. Thank you guys.